Welcome viewers. Today in our Proud Professional series, we make an endeavour to bring to you various people, professionals from different spheres. And we have a unique personality and a famous personality, Roma Khanna. She comes from the field of sports. She is the tournament director of the LOC for the FIFA U17 Women World Cup 2020. Hi Roma, and welcome to the Proud Professionals.
Thank you, Ruchi. Happy to be here.
Thanks. So Roma, actually, we would like to know what really is the role of a tournament director.
Well, our tournament director per se is responsible for the LOC's complete management, operational, day-to-day running, and in terms of the execution of the tournament in India. So that's, in a nutshell, that's what it is. On a day-to-day level, it could be anything, right, from the government guarantees that you have to do, to a security, to an accreditation. Everything that is pertaining to the tournament is the responsibility of the tournament director.
Oh, so this tournament becomes your baby.
Yes. My baby, my life for the next 1 year, that's all you can say. Basically, that's what I've been living and breathing for the last 6 months.
Oh, that's nice. And just to let you all know that Roma holds to credit a lot of the firsts within this field. So Roma, I understand that you were the first women from India to get a full sponsorship for the FIFA Masters program. So what is the FIFA Masters program?
So FIFA Masters program is basically one of the world's leading sports management program, which deals with, it's divided into three modules. One is management, humanities, and then the law part of it. Each module is conducted in three different countries in Europe, starting off in England, basically with humanities. Then you move to Italy and you do the management part of it. And then you move to Switzerland where you study the law and then you graduate from the course. Okay. So that's what FIFA Masters is. On an average, they select around 30 students globally, and I've been privileged to have been part of it. And next year we celebrate our 10th anniversary of the, at least for my edition, from doing the FIFA Masters.
Oh, wow. Yes. So as you heard, she has been into this field of football and FIFA for the last 10 years. But I would like to mention that she started her career as a sports journalist. So how was the change from a sports journalist to admin side?
Okay, I think to be honest, that was a much easier transition to make than considering the background that I come from. You'd probably be surprised to know I actually have a master's in mathematical economics and statistics. But I was looking to do actuarial science. It's a very interesting thing. I was looking to study actuarial science, and I had, what do you say, 3-4 month break. And Z News at that point of time were looking for to recruit. And I just went in thinking it's just going to be like a 3-4 month thing, which turned out to be, what do you say, a career in journalism. And post that, it was more about making that transition, because at the end of the day, you're doing sports journalism, and sports industry with IPL and other tournaments was just about to start. So you thought, you need to be better prepared, you need to be a leader, you need to be at the forefront. So what better way than to educate yourself? Professionally, what do you say? A lot of my friends tell me I'm a professional student. I have a master's, like I mentioned, in mathematical economics. I have a FIFA master's. I also have a master's in marketing and communications. So it's about, what do you say, developing your skill sets and then making that transition from, what do you say, journalism to administration, which was not difficult, to be honest. When I moved back to India, the more difficult transition was finishing your studies in Europe and then coming back to India and then getting into a very unstructured industry. That was a bigger challenge, I'd say.
Okay. But I think you're a great role model for people, because actually what happens is normally people would kind of be in the same field. If you've taken a profession, you've studied a line, people just find areas of getting higher into it. But I think you've helped people understand that you can take the courage of making a shift.
I think to me that it is. It's probably, to be honest, if you put your mind to it, it's one of the easiest things to do. If you make up your mind and you decide that, you know what, this is not what I want to do, it's easy to make that change, because the more you continue and the more you divert, it doesn't work. At least it did not work for me, because to be honest, we should all also realize that we spend more than half our day at work. So if you're not really productive and happy at what you're doing, you're not really happy at your home life as well. You take that unhappiness, a little bit of frustration back to work. But if you're having fun with what you're doing at work, you take that same joy back home to your family, to your friends and everything in your life. That's what I believe in.
Oh, yeah, right. And I think for you now, it's been sports. So play at work is what we should be saying.
Actually, to be honest, to be funnily enough, when I was a cricket journalist, I was more in tune with what was going on in the world of sports. Making that transition into administration, it has become less and less about sports and more in terms of putting things together. So there isn't a day when I go and I watch a football match and I'm not looking and saying, oh, the perimeter boards are fine, the lighting probably is there, the pitch looks better. Or when I used to basically work again in journalism as well, I would not look at the stroke of Sachin Tendulkar or the bowling of Anil Kumble. I would think, okay, now I have a life link and this is Sunil Gavaskar is supposed to come for a shoot and XYZ needs to be there. So you tend to lose that. You start thinking more in terms of work than the original reason that got you into sports. Gone were the days when in 1996, I would say long time back for a lot of viewers, when India was playing Pakistan in Bangladesh and you would see that Amir Sohail and Venkatesh swings and you would enjoy those games and then fight with your parents and say, no, I want to watch cricket. I don't want to study for my examinations or anything of that sort. To now where you're like, okay, I'm not going to watch this because I have these things to
priorities.
Put in place for the tournament.
The priorities change.
Exactly. Those things change actually, to be honest.
So since we've been talking about this, I would like to know, how do you see women within this field? Because you're happy to see women sufficient enough in the space, or
there's always room for improvement. We need more women in leadership roles. That is one of the positives I would say with the FIFA Under 17 Women's World Cup that we're looking to see. If you see over here, the percentage of women in the team is a lot more higher than you would have seen in a previous tournament as well. If you look at it from my own journey, I was the only woman head of the department for the 2017 tournament for boys, and over here right now I have three head of the departments, out of which two of them are women, and each of them have qualified on merit to be where they are. So to be honest, we need to look a little bit more. We need to basically think out of the box as well, and we need to think in terms of gender equity. It's not about men or women, it's about finding the right person for the job. That's what my journey has been, being the right person, doing the right things, and which is where each and every one, I would say, in the team, be it women or be it men, are over here as well.
So you know, and I can see the passion in things railing out of you, so I would not like to ask you what really drives you, because I think your work is driving you and you're enjoying what you're doing. So the passion is what I can see. I just like to just ask you one thing, because you did mention about your change from an international location to India and an unstructured organization or whatever you can say that. How do you, see things in India on the sports element?
I'll give you two examples. Basically, I'll first talk about probably the pre-transition phase, more in terms of journalism and in terms of how it is perceived. If you're talking per se to women, right? So I'll give you an example. It was 2005, the England tour, India versus England in England. And you had, like, at that point of time, a lot more women journalists who were there. And then I remember one of the selectors, who are national team selector, who I wouldn't like to name, and he said, "Arey Roma, ye kya hai? Itni saari ladkiyan cricket field mein kya kar rahi hain?" They were not used to the fact that women were journalists. It is basically a job. It does not matter whose job it is. But cricket got used to that change, that transition. And right now what we see is football also slowly and steadily gearing towards that change. What my transition from the Indian, I can tell you about my own journey. It's much easier to talk in terms of your own rather than give you a general one. The other one would be the transition from within India. I'll give you an example. We had, for the 2017 tournament, we had one of the inspections taking place in Calcutta at one of the training sites. So it was a FIFA inspection and there were 3-4 men and I was there. So there was one of the directors from one of the training site facilities. Someone walked in and he said, "Madam, agar aap bura nahi manengi, aap wahan sofa par baith jayenge." And we were, I'm not used to someone who's basically ever witnessed, gender disparity or this kind of a situation. Okay, I've always worked in a liberal side. I was like, "What?" And my boss from the other side was like, "No." I was like, "Of course not." I said, "Q, he's like, mera banda yahan par hai na, inko ye discussion ke liye yahan par baithna hai, isiliye we were all horrified. Because none of them, they were all foreigners, and me, I never worked in a culture where I had faced this kind of harassment, what do you say? I said, no, of course not. And before I could say something, it was my boss who stood up and he said, well, if she doesn't have a place over here, neither do we. We'll all sit over here till you finish your discussion. Mm-hmm. She's the head of the venue. She's the one who runs it. Mm-hmm. So if she doesn't find any role, neither do we. And to be honest, that's exactly what we need in terms of journey. That from 2000, end of 2014 to what do you say, we say exactly 5 years down the line, in 19, we see a lot more understanding, a lot more change, a lot more, awareness that it's about the role that matters. However, yes, a lot of challenges are there and a lot of change still needs to be made. Yes.
No, and I think the needle is shifting, as you're saying. Yes. And in some places it's shifting faster, while some places it may be taking a longer time. So I think, yeah. And I think those efforts are being made on all sides to make that shift. So yeah. So thanks, Roma. I think that's nice. I think one last question I would have, and just being constrained of time, is like, what is your message or thought for our newer generation that's coming up? How should they look at overall their career, you know, as a profession, not necessarily sports, any field that they choose, what any, you know, mantras you can say or any suggestions?
I would basically see a lot of things I've mentioned to you at the start. I'm probably a professional student. We have a lot of freshers who come over here. I always say, whatever it is you choose it because you want to do that. You have that passion, you have that belief. Even if at times you face parental restriction, at the end of the day, parents love their children. So they will support you. That's their job. They are going to support you no matter what. Learn from mistakes. If you don't like it, don't be scared to make the change. Try something new till you find what exactly is your passion, and that will reward you in the future. That's exactly what you need to think. That's my advice to young professionals, I'd say.
So thanks, thanks Roma. It was really nice, and I think what each and every bit of it that you said has been a great story, and I think people will understand and they will shift more towards sports. Not even if towards sports, they will try and follow their dreams and passions and make the effort to follow it. So keep watching Radio Dwarka, subscribe to us, and look forward for such inspirational stories on the proud profession.